tips for overcoming social anxiety as an entrepreneur. For those who don't know me, I'm Kim, and I help female entrepreneurs to overcome anxiety and perfectionism that is holding them back from scaling their biz in 21 days. So let's get into it. Okay, so some people say that your network equals your net worth. So dealing with social anxiety as an entrepreneur can feel really challenging because you're like, I need to go out there and network, whether that's online or in person. But then like the anxiety creeps in and starts making you be like, am I good enough? Like, what if everyone hates me? Like, all the things. And I totally get it because I have definitely been there. I used to suffer from like crippling social anxiety, and it made it really hard to do things like this because I would always be so self-conscious. I would go into the room and like not know who to talk to. I would feel really nervous. I would be like, oh my God, is anyone gonna take me seriously? All the feelings. It can feel really scary to go into a room with like a bunch of other people and just like have to talk to them and also make a good impression. Like, it can feel really scary. And for those of us who are maybe like a bit more introverted, it can just feel like the worst thing ever. And there's a couple reasons for this, that we have like this social anxiety. Like, the first one is you're probably not in your worth. And so when you don't feel worthy and deserving of taking up space or being somewhere, then you're going to be really anxious when you show up because you're making other people's opinion about you more important than your opinion about yourself. And this is really important because a lot of us are really, we're taught from such a young age, like, what are other people going to think of me? Like, how will this impact other people? Like, what does this person think? We're not really taught to value our own opinion of ourselves more than anyone else's. But the thing is, the way that people treat us is always a reflection of how we are treating ourselves. So self-worth is really at the core of like everything that I teach and everything that I help people with, because when you believe that you're worthy and deserving of like being in there, taking up that space, then you're going to show up in a completely different way, and it will help alleviate some of that anxiety because then you know that you're worthy of being there, you have something to say, you have a purpose for being there. It completely changes the reason that you're in the room. And then also knowing that like humans, we have two main drives. Like, we want to be connected and we want to avoid rejection. And this really stems from that primal urge of like, we needed to be connected to our tribe and not get cast out, because a long time ago that would have meant like death. Like, you're not able to survive if you're just like a person out there trying to fend for themselves and like hunt and all the things. But the thing is we don't live in those circumstances anymore. So if we get rejected by someone now, it's like, well, there's like 7 billion people on the planet, somebody else will like you. Like, but our nervous system in our brain, like the old version of it in there, like the prehistoric brain, it doesn't understand that. And that's the really primal part of your brain that's like controlling that fear. And so that's why it's like in your mind, you can be like, okay, I shouldn't be afraid of this, but your body is telling you something completely different. And I think the amazing thing about knowing this is when you have that knowledge and you have that awareness of what's going on, it makes it a whole lot less scary, because you're not like, why do I have like massive anxiety and fear every time I go into this or talk to other people? You understand that it's really just coming from those two main drives of being connected and avoiding rejection, which is like understandable, but also knowing that in this point in time, you're not gonna die if you're not connected to other people. Like, most of us now, we could live quite self-sufficiently by ourselves. You go to the store, you buy your food, no lions are coming to attack you, like, you're good. But we still are hardwired to seek out that connection and avoid that rejection. And this is a big part of what shows up when we have social anxiety and like dealing with people. And another thing that I think is really worth mentioning, that as humans, we regulate our nervous system based on the people that we're around. So if we're like really in that fight or flight, we're super anxious, we're super nervous, that's the energy that we're giving off. And that's what people feel coming off of us. And like, even if they're not conscious of it, it feels kind of weird to them. And then they start to get a little anxious. So it's like, we kind of have like this volleying back and forth of our nervous systems all like really getting riled up and getting really anxious. subconscious. So a way that you can overcome this is learning how to work with it and understanding how to mitigate this and bring your body back into a state of feeling calm and feeling grounded. So I'm going to give you 4 tips on how you can do that. You can start to do this every day if you want to. You can use it before you go to events. You can use it before you need to speak to people. It's really good to learn how to regulate your own nervous system, because when you start to realize what's going on and you really tune into your body and understand the feelings of what's happening, then you don't get swept away by the anxiety or the panic, because you start to recognize what's going on and you're like, okay, this thing is happening, so I can do something to mitigate this instead of just letting it run wild, and then you feel really anxious and you feel really icky and then you have a bad time. So the first thing is noticing your thought patterns when you interact with others. Your mind works like this beautiful biofeedback machine of what you put in is what's going to come out. So if you are heading into an event and you're like, I hate talking to people, I don't want to be here, everyone's going to hate me, they're judging me, I'm not good enough, I look bad in this outfit. If that's what you're giving yourself, then that's what you're going to get back out. Those are the feelings that you're going to receive, because your brain hears that and it's like, oh, okay, you don't really want to be here. It doesn't sound like this is a good time. Maybe we should run away from this. So then it's straight away those thoughts are creating a feeling that feels really bad, and then that just spirals on and on. And the more that you think a thought, the more it encodes as a belief. So the more time you've spent doing this, the more ingrained that is going to be as a belief for you. But so when you start doing this and you see those thoughts coming up and you start feeling a way that doesn't feel good to you, start tapping in and be like, what are the thoughts that I'm thinking right now? And is this thought ultimately true? Because the only reason that we're suffering in the present moment is the way that we're thinking about the situation that we're experiencing in the present moment. And you can't control anything in life except for your thinking and yourself. Everything else is happening, and ultimately it's out of your control, and we just have to be okay with that. But we can control how we respond to things. We can control how we show up. So we can really control the way that we respond to the situation and start examining our thoughts and be like, okay, this thought is not true. It doesn't make me feel good. What's a better feeling thought that I could reach for? And you're not trying to go from 0 to 100. You're not going to go from panic attack to a Zen monk in 2 seconds, but you can start to build up the space in between that stimulus and the reaction time. You can start to when you have that reaction, you can be like, okay, what am I thinking right now? What's a better feeling thought? How could I think about this differently? The next one is having techniques to shift your state. So if you understand at the core of it that anxiety is a physical reaction to what's going on, and your body is always taking cues on how to feel from your thinking and your physiology. And so when I say that, I mean your body posture, how fast you're breathing, how you're standing, are you standing with your shoulders really hunched and you're trying to protect yourself and breathing really shallow in your chest, or are you open and breathing slowly from your diaphragm? And so you can control that physiology to a certain degree, and once you become aware of it, you can be like, okay, am I standing in a way where I feel confident, and am I breathing in a way that feels good, it's not telling my body that we're about to need to run away from something, and some of the really good some really good techniques to shift your state or your physiology is, the first one, just turn on some happy music really loud and just shake your whole body, shake it all out, shift that stagnant energy, just get it out. Or you can do tapping. There's lots of videos on YouTube. You can do havening, which is super easy to do anywhere and just floods your brain with good feeling chemicals, which is you're just going like this. Maybe you heard about it because Justin Bieber was doing it, but you just do this over and over until you feel a sense of calm. You can do it anywhere, which is really powerful. And if you're able to, splashing some cold water on your face can really also help to regulate your nervous system and calm it down. And you just want to be aware of your body posture and how you're showing up. And then the third one, and this is a bit of a longer term thing, but you can use hypnosis to shift your beliefs on a subconscious level. So if those thoughts that just are happening and you're feeling it's really automatic, you're not even aware of it, you can't imagine it being a different way, I really recommend either doing a session with me in RTT or listening to hypnosis recordings. I have some on my website if you want to check them out. And those will shift your beliefs over time so that your behavior becomes different, because there's this really amazing Carl Jung quote, which I absolutely love, which is like until you make the unconscious conscious, it will direct your life and you will call it fate. So this is like when your beliefs are like controlling your life so much that you don't even realize that those are like beliefs that you adopted at some point in time. You think it's just how it is for everyone, and it's really not, because unless you could say something is true for absolutely everyone, then it's not absolutely true for you, which is really powerful. And so the fourth one is just being mindful in the present moment. When you are feeling really like overwhelmed, stressed, panicked, anxious, bring it back to the present moment and start like looking at like, okay, what are five things you can see? What are five things you can smell? What are five things you can feel? Like really bringing it back to this very present moment. Anxiety shows up when you're living in the future. And so if you're like future tripping and like mind reading for other people and deciding how they must feel about you, then you're not being present in your experience. So on a very basic level, just bringing it back to being present in your current experience, and that's going to help you to kind of like ground back into feeling safe in your body. So just to recap quickly, noticing your thought patterns, using empowering language for yourself, how you're speaking to yourself, having techniques to shift your state, whether that's like dancing, havening, tapping, whatever. The third one is using hypnosis or RTT to shift your beliefs on a subconscious level so that you can show up differently with less effort. It doesn't have to be conscious anymore. Your body will automatically do it for you. And then fourth is just being mindful in the present moment. So I hope this was helpful for you. If you're struggling with anxiety or perfectionism and you want to get rid of it, book in a call with me and we can chat about how I can help you overcome it. I hope you have an incredible day, and I will talk to you soon.